Good morning students, once again welcome back to computer science class. Today here I am going to explain the storage structure RAID level. Okay, so it is a technology, storage technology, which combines multiple disk into a single unit. Like example, this is a disk, three disk we have, which is equals to one main disk. That is nothing but the RAID level. Okay, it is a storage structure. It is a virtualized storage structure where multiple disks are combined into a single unit to provide a high storage and high performance. Okay, so and how these disks are arranged, what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages, in coming topic I will explain. Okay, just the time being, it is a technology which combines multiple disks into a single unit for providing high storage structure. Okay, now when you come to this topic, the key points are the full form of this: redundant array of inexpensive or independent disk. Inexpensive or independent. Why it is called as inexpensive? Because instead of taking three disks, we are taking only one disk. Okay, and each and every disk is a separate. Okay, that is why it is called as an independent or inexpensive disk. Okay. It is an array. Array means it is a collection of disk. That is why it is called as an array. Next, it is a storage visualization technology. Okay, visualization, and it is a virtualization technology. It is also called as a virtualization. Actually, what we think, there is only single unit we think, but internally the multiple disks are arranged into a single unit. Okay. The next one is each and every disk drives are independent. These are clubbed, but in reality each and every disk is a independent disk. Next, it uses two or three disks. Instead of using a single disk, here minimum 2 to 3 disks we are clubbed into a single disk. It is an array. Array means what? It is more than one. One example, one disk is used to provide 4 GB, 6 GB storage. When you combine this type of three disks, then how much storage you can provide? 12 GB storage you can provide. Okay, and it will occupy the less space, and it will reduces the fault tolerance. Actually, what is the fault tolerance? Is example, you have a one disk. Okay, in the one disk you are storing a data. Because of any hardware or software failure, if the data is lost from this hard disk, that is called as a fault tolerance. Okay, it is a fault. Means, but instead of maintaining data in one disk, if you are maintaining same copy in multiple disk, if one disk is failed, at least you will get data in a second and third disk. Okay, so that is called as a no fault tolerance. Means, if any file or any data lost because of any technical reason, if you are using a RAID levels, that data you can gain again. Okay, that is the main use of this RAID level. The same copy is maintained on multiple disks. So if one disk is failed, whatever data is there in that failed disk, that you can take a backup from a second disk. That is called as a fault tolerance. And the data is distributed in several ways. Whatever data is there in one disk, that you can store in a second disk, third disk and fourth disk, or the data is split into blocks. There are different ways you can store data in a different hard disk. Okay, different disk. Actually, it is not exactly hard disk, it is a disk. So this is about RAID level. Only the thing is multiple disks are arranged in a single unit. Why we are arranging multiple disks into a single unit? In order to provide huge storage, big storage to the user, we are clubbing, we are combining multiple disks into a single unit. So that is why it is called as a RAID level. It is an independent. And redundancy means what actually? Redundant array of inexpensive. Redundant means what? Duplication of data. Duplication of data means the same data is maintained in multiple locations. Then that is called as a redundancy. Actually, you have this in a database also. In a DBMS, in the fourth sem, you have DBMS. There you have a redundancy. One of the concept of a database management system. Redundancy means duplication of data, like it's a Xerox copy. So in a RAID, what we are doing is whatever data is there in one disk, the same data is maintaining in a multiple disk. So duplicate copy you are maintaining. Why we maintain a duplicate copy? Because if one copy is lost, whatever data is there, you can recover from a second copy. Okay, that is a redundant. So redundant array of inexpensive disk. Redundant array. Array means what? More than one. So the duplicate copies are maintained in more than one place, in more than one disk. That is a RAID. Okay. So this is about the introduction of RAID level. Okay. Actually, what is a RAID level? The same copy, the same data is maintained on multiple disks. Clear? So when you are maintaining same data on a multiple disk, there are different ways. There are different features here that we'll discuss now. And whatever features are there, that are distributed among different levels. So here in RAID level, we have a number of levels, 0 to 6, total 7 levels we have. And in each and every level, there is a separate storage, there is a separate size and a separate performance. Okay, that we'll discuss now. First we'll discuss about the RAID level one. First I'll give you the list of the RAID level, then I will explain each and every level. Okay, so here we have a different levels of RAID, and each and every level is based on one characteristics. Example, RAID 0 is based on a striping, and RAID 1 is based on the mirror. Means each and every level there is a specialization of data storage. That we'll discuss in each and every level, but mainly right now only RAID 0, RAID 1, RAID 4 and 6 are using nowadays. This 2, 3, 5 nowadays we are not using, but even though what are the key points are there about this, that I will explain. Okay, just you take a screenshot of this. Different levels we have. In the exam, they may ask any level, like a 0, 1 or 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that they will ask. And whatever key points are there in that level, that you should explain. Clear? You take a screenshot of this, I will explain RAID 0. Now, come to a RAID 0. Here the RAID levels start from a 0 to 6, total 7 levels we have. The RAID 0, it is main works on striping. Actually, what is a striping is, example, you have this much data. The total data is divided into blocks. Okay? Example, block 1, block 2, block 3. And this data stored on the disk like this. Okay? Example, this disk. This is called as a striping. Okay? So the RAID 0 is it is based on the striping. In the striping, whatever data is there, whatever data the user wants to store, the total data is divided into blocks. That process is called as a striping. And here in a stripe, in a RAID level 0, minimum 2 disks are used. Minimum 2 disks, and whatever data the user wants to store, that data is divided into different blocks and alternative blocks. Like example, if you have a block 1, block 2, block 3, block 4. Block 1, block 3 stored in a disk 1. Block 2, block 4 stored in a second disk. Okay. So that is a striping. Clear? So the main thing is RAID level 0 is based on the striping. Whatever data the user wants to store, the total data is divided into different blocks. Okay, and alternative blocks are stored in one disk. Okay, and whatever block size is there, that is called as a chunk. C-U-N-K, chunk size. Clear? Now, it is based on the striping. Key points we'll discuss now. Based on the striping. Means the total data is divided into blocks. Next, data is divided into blocks and each and every block is called as a chunk. Next, here, example, here we have a two disk. Imagine. Two disks, and the data is divided, that disk is divided into blocks. And here, whatever data you are sending, that is also divided into blocks. Example, we have six blocks. Block 1, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6. So, B1, B2, next B3, B4, B5, B6, like that. So this procedure is called as a striping. Okay, the whatever data is there, that data is divided into blocks. Clear? Next, here when we lose this is when the performance, where the performance is giving a higher priority, in that cases we'll use this type of rail. Why? Because here, what is the total size of storage? Here is the sum of two disks. So when you want to store a large amount of data, there we'll use this type of storage. And here, when you are coming to a read operation and write operation, when you are when you want to read the content, then what happened? Wherever that block is there, that will be read. And whenever you want to write the content, simultaneously two disks will in the two disks you can store the data. So what happened? Very fastly you can store the data. One block in a one disk and a second block is in a second disk. So in that way you can increase the performance of the write operation. Okay. Next, it is the total capacity is sum of disk. Example, this disk is a 4 GB. And this disk is a 4 GB. So what is the total storage capacity? It's a 8 GB. The total storage capacity is sum of the disk are available. Clear? And here there is no redundant data. Whatever data is there, that are split into the parts, but the duplicate copy is not maintained. So that is why here there is no question of redundancy. When there is no redundancy, what it means indirectly, you can store large volume of data in a RAID level 0. Okay, which increases the storage performance of the system. Next term, zero redundancy, I've explained. But here, what disadvantage you have? Due to any technical reason, if one disk is failed, whatever blocks are available in this RAID level 0, that will be lost. That will be the disadvantage. And one more is, whatever data is there, that should be split into parts, and one part is in a one disk and a second part is in a second disk. So that partitioning is a overhead to the system. Clear? RAID level, we have a number of advantages, RAID level 0. But at the same time, we have a disadvantage. Because there is a fault tolerance. Means if there is data is lost due to any reason, that you cannot recover. Okay? Because there is no redundant. Right? Striping means here, whatever data is, that is split. But the duplicate copy is not maintained. So if the copy is lost, the main copy is lost, there is no way to recover that content. Okay, that only the disadvantage you have in a RAID level 0. Okay, now we'll discuss about RAID level 1. Come here, we'll discuss about RAID level 1. Okay, RAID level 1. RAID level 1 is based on the mirroring. Mirroring means, example, this is one hard disk or one disk. And in this disk, we are storing a block 1, block 2, block 3, block 4, example. As I already said, whatever data is there, that data is split into parts and each and every part is called as a block. And that blocks are stored in a disk. So here how many blocks have stored? 4 blocks have stored. And this is one disk, disk 1. Mirroring means what? The same data stored in another disk. Like B1, B2, B3, B4. Okay, this is a mirroring. So in the RAID level 1, we are following the mirroring characteristics. Means whatever data is there, that is stored in a one disk and the same copy is maintained in another disk. Means there is two identical disks are maintained in the storage. Okay, why we are maintaining the two identical copies is, if one disk is failed due to any reason, whatever content is there, that you can recover from a second disk. So that is why we are maintaining identical copy, Xerox copy we are maintaining. Okay, so that is why RAID level 1 is based on the mirroring technology. Mirroring, same copy is maintained. Okay, now what are the key points here is, it is based on the mirroring, means a duplicate disk is maintained. Whatever data is there, whatever data you are storing in one disk, the same another disk is maintained with the same copy. Next, identical copies are maintained. Minimum two disks should be there. Minimum. If you want to maintain 3-4 disks also, you can maintain. But how many minimum disks should be maintained? Minimum two disks should be maintained. Clear? Now, read performance is improved. Read performance. See, example. Why read performance is improved means, you want to read the content. So when you want to read the content, if one disk is busy with the write operation, you can read content from another disk. Okay,
So when you want to read the content, multiple disks are available. Whichever disk is idle, that disk can provide a read operation. Okay, so that is why read performance is increased in a RAID level 1. Because whatever content is there, that is available on minimum 2 disks. If one disk is busy, one disk is not performing any action example, the second disk, it can provide the content. Okay, so with a fraction of second, you will get, you can perform read operation using a RAID level 1. Clear? Now, when come to a write, reader, after this reader, you have a write also. But when you come to write operation, it is overhead actually. Because whatever content is there, you are maintaining a multiple copies. You are writing in a multiple places. So when you come to a write operation, the performance of this level decreases. Okay, but it is providing a security for your data. If data is lost, you will get from another disk. But the thing is, in both the disk, you have to write the content. So when you come to a write operation, the performance of RAID level will decrease. Come to a read when compared to a read operation. Reading, you can read from any disk. But when you want to write the content, whatever content is there, that you have to write in a two disk. Okay, two times. So it will decrease. It is overhead to the system. But when you come to a security recovery, that is a more beneficial compared to a this write operation. Next, here fault tolerance means if one disk is failed due to any reason, easily you can recover that content from another disk. Okay, so this is about RAID level. So RAID level is based on the mirroring. It will maintain minimum 2 disk. Okay, 2 identical copies. Okay, 2 disk means 2 identical copies. Two disk in the two disk we are maintaining the same copy. So that is nothing but the identical copies. Why we are maintaining identical copy? Because if due to any reason if one disk is failed, you can recover content from another disk. Okay, read operation, it means very fastly you can perform the read operation. When you come to write operation, it is a little bit overhead compared to the RAID level 0. Clear? And there is fault tolerance means if content is lost due to any reason, easily you can recover that content from another disk. And here 100% redundant data is maintained, because whatever data is there in the disk 1, the same data you are maintaining at disk 2 also. Clear? So 100% redundancy data is there. Redundancy is there. Clear? Because it is mirroring. Come to advantages. Read operation you can perform very easily. Okay? And 100% fault tolerance means if the disk is failed, you can easily recover. Okay? And security for your data. When you come to disadvantages, 2 copies should be maintained. Storage capacity is only the 50%. Example, if you have taken only the 80 GB disk, out of 80 GB, 40 GB is used for only the 40 GB is used for storing the content. Remaining 40 GB is used for maintaining a duplicate copy. So 50% of the storage is wasting. Okay, fault tolerance is there, but storage. And when you come to a write operation in multiple places, we have to write. So that is also an overhead. Few disadvantages we have, but the main advantage is recovery of data. If the data is lost in one disk, easily you can recover from another disk. That is the main advantage, which is not possible in a RAID level 0. RAID level 0, read operation, write operation is fast. But if data is lost in the RAID level 0, that is not recovered. But in case of RAID 1, if data is lost, then easily you can recover from another disk, because it is providing 100% redundancy. Clear? So this is about RAID level 1. Now we'll discuss about RAID level 2. Now come to a RAID level 2. RAID level 2, again, it works based on striping only. So but in case of RAID level 0, RAID level 1, whatever data is there, that data is divided into different blocks. But here, whatever data is there, that data is divided into bits, bit level striping. So previously in a RAID 0, RAID level, whatever data is there, that blocks are stored in a one disk example, first block in a first disk, second block is in a second disk, third block is in a third disk. So here what we are doing is whatever bits are there, first bit in a first disk, second bit in a second disk, third bit is in a third disk. When it will come to the eighth disk, the total one byte is over. Next, the further bytes are used for the error correction code ECC. It is based on the Hamming code. Means if any bit is missed, that information you can verify with the ECC code, error correction code ECC. Okay. So here we'll discuss about the key points. It uses a bit level striping. So whatever data is there, that is divided into a bit level. Next, bits are the combination of data and error code. Whatever bits you are storing in between. We are using an error correction code also in order to check whether all the bits are stored properly or not. Okay. Next, this uses Hamming code. That is the one type of error correction code. And whatever data is there, for each and every data, it calculates the ECC code. Whenever you are storing, whenever you are transferring data from one disk to the another disk, it will calculate the sending data and receiving data using a this ECC code, error correction code. Okay, but nowadays we are not using this because you need to maintain separate storage capacity, because it required more storage capacity, one for storing data and one for error correction. So it is a cost consuming, so that is why nowadays no one is offering this. Okay, and every time you have to calculate the error correction code, you have a security. Means if data is lost, easily you can verify that. But the thing is, you need to every time you need to calculate whatever sent data with the ECC. So it is a time consuming process and it required more space to store the data, to store error information. So nowadays that is why no one is using this RAID level 2. Okay, now we'll discuss about RAID level 3. So in RAID level 3 also we are using, it is based on the striping only, but here instead of the bit level, the striping is for a byte. Okay, and multiple disks are maintained, and example, minimum 3 disks should be maintained, and out of that 3, 2 disks are used for a data and 1 disk used for the parity information. What is the parity information is, again it is a error correction mechanism, because if any byte is lost, that information will get in a parity disk, that is an extra disk. It is an, again it is an overwrite to the system, but it should be maintained, because if any byte is lost, that information you can get from a parity. So it is a collection of data and parity byte. Next, multiple disk used for data and striping. Example, if you have a 3 disk, out of that 3 disk, 2 disk used for a data and 1 disk used for a parity information. Parity information is nothing but it is used to find out like if any byte is lost, that information you can find out in a parity disk. Okay, so that is why parity disk is a extra disk which is maintained to check whether all the bytes are transferred properly or not. Next, your minimum 3 drives should be used. Minimum 3 disk drives should be used. You know, RAID level. Minimum 3 disk used. Okay, why minimum? Out of that 3, 2 used for the data and 1 used for the error correction. Actually, how this error correction is example, byte 2, 3, 4 is transferred. That information you will get in a disk information. But at the sending, at the receiver side, if we received only 2, 3, 4 is not received, that information you can find out using a parity. So that is why in a RAID 2, RAID 3, RAID 4, they are using a ECC, error correction code, and the parity information to find out whether that whatever data is sent, that is received properly or not. Okay, but it is not commonly used. Okay, RAID 2, RAID 3 and RAID 4 also maximum we won't use. We'll use 5 and 6 and 10 also we'll use. And that 5, 6, 10 is based on this only. Okay, next we'll discuss about RAID 4. That is also small few points you have in that also I will explain. So come to RAID level 4. Again it is based on the block level striping. Means whatever data is there, that are split into different blocks, and that blocks are stored in a different disk, and extra one disk is maintained to store the parity information. Actually, when the what is the use of the parity information here is, if any disk is failed due to any reason, then this parity byte, what it will do is, it will collect that information from a different disk, because it will compare the receiving and sending information. If it is not matches, then it will restore all the blocks. That is the use of the parity. And this the RAID level 4 is, it is a combination of parity information and this data level. But parity information is stored in a separate disk, and a few disks are maintained for this data. And if disk is failed due to the any information, due to the any reason, this parity byte is used to recover that information. Okay. And this block read access only one disk, means whenever if you want to read any content, only one block is read from a one disk. And if you want to access the second block and the third block, the user is directed to use another disk, not in the same disk. Means one disk is provide a read operation only, means at a time it will provide only one read operation to the user. Okay, so this is about RAID level 4. In the RAID level 4, only few points are there. Whatever data is there, that data is divided into different parts, and that is a dividing process called as a striping. But striping is for a block level, okay, not for the bit level, not for the byte level. So whatever blocks are there, that blocks are stored in a different disk. Example, if you have a 4 disk, out of that 4 disk, 3 disks are maintained for a data and 1 disk is maintained for a parity. Why we are using a parity? Because if this data disk failed due to any reason, that parity disk is used to recover that data from a remaining disk. And whenever the user want to read any content, the user can at a time, the user can read from one disk only, means block from one disk only. If you want to read the second block at the same time, that information is provided by that block is provided by the second disk. Okay, this is about RAID level 4. Similarly, 5, 6, same. Whatever total data is there, that total data is divided into blocks. Okay, but in case of 5 and 6, byte, this parity information will use to maintain in the same disk. In 3, 4, what happened, that parity information is say maintained in a separate disk, in a separate place. But in case of 5 and 6, what happened, whatever parity information is there, that will be maintained in the same disk. Means if the disk is failed, in the same disk only you will get that error information also. That is a parity. So in come to a RAID level 6, parity information is maintained, but double parity information is maintained in a RAID level 6. In a RAID level 5, only one parity information, but in RAID level 6, two bytes parity information you will get. Okay, now come to RAID level 10. RAID level 10 is, it is a combination of 1 plus 0. Okay, 0 plus 1 means whatever features you have in a RAID level 0 and RAID level 1, all the features you can combine into a RAID level 10, because it is a combination of 1 plus 0. Okay, understood? It will provide the storage capacity, second storage capacity with the mirror facility. Means the same duplicate copies are maintained in a 1-0. Okay, so this is about RAID level. If you have any doubt in this RAID level, we'll discuss in a live class. Okay.